Hello guys, welcome back. Today we will be talking about how to add zebra crosswalk on the road in your render.
Just do it!
So first of all, I will be making the zebra crosswalk material and I will be leaving the textures down below in the description. Start by creating a V-Ray material, click on the diffuse and drag, choose bitmap and pick the diffuse texture. Then drag from the diffuse to the reflect glossiness. We will be using the same map here since the two are very similar. After that, drag from the reflect map and choose the RGB multiply. Then change the color 2 to 150. You can adjust the color 2 to fit your needs. Then drag from the color 1 and add the reflect bitmap. After that, drag from bump, choose V-Ray and go to V-Ray normal map. From V-Ray normal map, drag and choose the normal bitmap, click on override and add it. Now the last but most important, go to the opacity, drag and add the opacity bitmap. You can also go to output and increase the output amount so that the material looks good enough for you. And that, guys, is how we make the zebra crosswalk material that we will be adding to the road in the rest of this video. So now let's consider you already made your road material since this video is about adding a crosswalk to the road. If you want a road creation material, let me know in the comments below or just email me. I will be leaving my email in the description. So anyway, to have the results shown in the beginning of the video, we will need to blend the two materials. So let's right click and add a V-Ray blend material. Now join the road to the base and join the zebra crosswalk to the coat 1. You see now in the material display the crosswalk overlays on the road. Now go add a new UVW map, turn off real world scale and change map channel from 1 to 2. Now go to the crosswalk bitmaps and change every map channel to 2. This will allow us to move the crosswalk textures and scale it in the new UVW map without changing the UVW map of the road. Now what you need to do is adjust your crosswalk in the UVW map. When you open your real-time renderer, you notice that the crosswalk is in the wrong direction. To fix that, go to the UVW map we just added, pick Gizmo, and rotate scale it until you get the result that you want. Now we do realize that we have a repetition of our crosswalk texture. So to fix that, go to each bitmap and turn off both the UV tiles. And that is how we get this beautiful crosswalk material. Well, don't leave yet. I will be talking about how to make smaller scale bands in the remaining of this video. So stay tuned. Now to get a smaller scale bands, you will need to go back to the material editor, pick each bitmap and turn on U or V tile depending on the direction your road is facing. Then go back to the gizmo of the UVW map and scale it the way you want. Now lastly, let's add some puddles to the road for more realistic effects. What you need to do now is go to the material editor, select your road material, shift drag it to create a copy, then delete all the unnecessary maps and leave the diffuse only. Then double click on the bitmap, go to output, enable color map and drag it down to have a shadier material. You will need to keep dragging the amount until you have the result you really want. Now drag and link the new material to code 2, then go to blend 2, drag and drop and add the puddle map you intend to use. I will be also leaving the bitmap I used in the description below, but you can download any bitmap from Google. Now double click it, turn off real world scale and change map channel to 3. Now add a new UVW map and change its map channel to 3. Now the black part is the transparent part, while the white part is where your puddles will be appearing. Now open up your real-time render. If you increase the output amount, you will have, as you see, a much darker puddle. I will stick to an output amount of 2. And that would be it, guys. Hope it helped you in your renders. Don't forget to like and subscribe and let me know what you think in the comments. Thank you.